Pastrana and Bennett on the grid for the first battle. This is a little look at who they are, of course. Pastrana for Vermont Sports Car, Oliver Bennett for X-Ite Energy Racing. 38 and 29 in terms of their age. And six times USA Rally Champion, I think, gives you an example. He's actually, of course, also the reigning Nitro Rally Cross Champion, that Travis Pastrana. Hasn't had an absolutely amazing season. Didn't make the final for the first time ever in the history of Nitro Rally Cross, including 18 and 19 at Utah, last time in Sweden. So, with his State of the Nation speech, we did say to him, dude, if that goes wrong, you're going to have to post on Monday that aged badly. But so far, it's going well.
Yeah, and Travis has something to prove in more ways than one. And Ollie Bennett, he does as well. I mean, you got to think about his X-Ite teammate. You know, he's got to show Jensen Button what's up. So these bracket battles, a cool, interesting format that we debuted this year. I really like it. Just makes for more racing, more excitement, more bragging rights.
I think also, you know, it, we were saying about how it goes at tennis or soccer style. You don't meet the top seeds until later. So at the minute, you're seeing battles which maybe won't be quite so close as we get through the process. It's going to get super tight.
All right. So again, these are the battle brackets quarterfinals. You'll see four of them all together. Whittle it down into the semis. Here we go. Who's going to get the jump? Travis Pastrana gets on that inside. Look at the attitude of that vehicle. You see him throwing it around, really aggressive there. Ollie Bennett has to back off. Now coming into that oval turn. Watch this big bank here. And I like what Travis said.
Bennett's in the wall, Jared, in the background.
Where you going, mate?
Too late on the brakes and just slid up super high. But remember, these guys, again, haven't run in these conditions. Their heat race was and he's broken the car. Bennett's put the car on the wall. So now if you're Pastrana spotter, you get on the radio and say, Travis, the other car is out. Yep. You can chill. So he can then take it a bit easier. Front right corner is off Bennett's car. There are the spotters up on the roof.
Yeah, he's done.
Yeah. Game over.
Yeah, you can see Travis spotter up there. He's telling, yep, he's done. He's through. So he's going to hold pace here and just continue on, and he will get the victory, moving him into the semifinals.
So I wonder if Travis will continue to get some feel. In theory, he knows Bennett's out, so he could stop now, and it goes on which vehicle's gone the furthest. And he backs off now, comes over the crest. Well, I think Travis will put the laps in, Jared, to feel the grip level. He's got a bye here, effectively. He's got a free run. He can just chill and feel the grip's like. He does need to make sure he doesn't go down Bennett's lane here. Don't follow Bennett's line into the wall either, Travis.
You saw him just track right into that wall.
He's tried that. Look, he's gone deep to get the apex on the exit. So Travis has tried an alternate line. This is basically an extra test session for him. Look at him feeling the grip down that back. It's ultra slick out there, really slippery.
Absolutely. So, like you said, this is a good free reign moment for him.
So clever.
Yeah. Some people are just kind of scratching their heads. They're like, electric? What's going on? Yeah, man. I mean, you know, all the manufacturers out there, they're going to electrification. You know, you name it, they're doing it. And I think this is just a progression of motorsports. You know, obviously, we love combustion engines.
Yeah, dude,
we're a sucker for it. We're a sucker for it. We love loud. We love all these things. What's interesting here is you hear that electric vibe, but what you do hear, you hear the gravel machine gun. You hear hitting the under tray, hitting the carbon fiber. It's just a different
experience. I've been lucky enough to ride in the car a couple of times. I'm determined to get you in one later this year, Jared, whether you want to or not. the gear shifts, you hear a big bang. These cars are actually, and you see Travis there use his fingers on the right paddle and just knock it down a gear. They've got three gears. They're running mostly in second and third. There's no need for first. It's just got so much grunt. They said unless you can really use all that power, and here they can't. So they're running the whole lap in second or third gear. And you hear the gear shifts, you hear the gravel on the bottom of the car. It's okay to miss the noise, that's fine. Nobody's saying you can't miss the noise, that's not allowed, that's fine. But these cars are absolutely awesome, and just the way they can handle the jumps and everything, fantastic.
All right, the Vermont sports car driver, that is Travis Pastrana. Speaking of the rifle, rocking that black rifle, coffee company logo on his chest. And there we go, bringing it on in, and Travis Pastrana gets the checkered flag.
Now, Travis didn't take a joke lap according to the timing screen, which would give him a penalty, but it doesn't matter because Bennett's retired. So then you have to ask, don't you, did he do that on purpose because he just wanted to try three standard laps, or did he forget about the joke? You know, did his spotter just go, I'm going back to the tent, it's fine, it's one. Good stuff.
All right, so the next opponent is either Erickson or Carlson. As we move into our battle semifinal one, our next bracket battle, Kevin Erickson. Again, there's the signature Travis thumbs up.
I love the fact he's straight on the radio, Jared. Here's Ollie Bennett going in the wall, and look, he actually goes in rear first, but then it's when it bounces off in. Front right corner, yeah, that's gone already. Look, there it goes. It goes on the exit, actually, as he comes out. Just one of the links breaks. A thousand horsepower do that when you've just stuck it in the wall. So, yeah, Bennett, unfortunately, game over there.